How do populations work? In biology, a population is all the organisms of the same group or species which live in a particular geographical area and have the capability of interbreeding. So what causes a population to increase? Two things that cause a population to increase are birth rates and immigration. With every birth inside of the particular species, populations grow and increase in size. Immigration also affects the growth of the population by adding to the existing size. But what causes a population to decrease? Death rates and emigration are two components that play a role in lowering growth rates. Death rates are the rate at which the individuals in a population die. If it is larger than the birth rate, then the population will decrease. Emigration can also cause a population to decrease, because it means that individuals are leaving or moving away from their home population. Species grow at different speeds. So how do we categorize the speed that these populations increase and decrease at? One categorized speed is exponential growth. Exponential growth is the increase of a population that grows more and more rapidly. This occurs when the needed resources of the population becomes unlimited. Another speed is logistic growth. In contrast to exponential growth, logistic growth is the decrease of a population. Populations are measured in geographic ranges. A geographic range is the place that a population lives in. The species inhabiting a geographic range can spread throughout them in different densities. These densities are categorized into three different types. The first is random, where the population is spaced across a geographic range unevenly. The second is uniform, where the population is spaced across a geographic range evenly. And the third is clumped, where several individuals of a population are packed closely together. One thing that all geographic ranges have in common is carrying capacity. Carrying capacity is the number of individuals of a species that an environment can support. Carrying capacity is determined by limiting factors. Limiting factors keep the population from increasing. There are two types of limiting factors. The first is density-dependent limiting factors, which are factors that operate more strongly when population densities are high. Examples of this are stress from overcrowding, parasitism, and disease. And for animals, density-dependent limiting factors can unbalance the predator-prey relationship as well. The second is density-independent limiting factors. Density-independent limiting factors are limiting factors that can affect any population, regardless of its size and density. Examples of density-independent limiting factors include natural disasters, such as floods, famine, tornadoes, hurricanes, droughts. If a natural disaster is drastic enough, it can wipe out entire geographic ranges and can cause entire species extinctions. Extinction can also occur if a carrying capacity drops low enough. So how do we compare population growth over time? Those who are specifically interested in human population growth go into the science of demography. Demography takes in information about populations, such as limiting factors and carrying capacities, and use it to determine the cause of demographic shifts and to predict future populations. These demographers have studied the growth patterns of the populations of the US and South America and have come up with a hypothesis to explain these countries' shifts in population size. They call it demographic transition. There are five stages in the demographic transition hypothesis. The first is a stable population with a slow increase. The second stage is a very rapid increase. The third stage is a slowing increase. Fourthly, the population decreases and then stabilizes. For the fifth stage, the population either remains stable or starts to decline slowly. But what about the rest of the world? Are they a part of demographic transition? The answer is no. India, China, and the sub-Saharan Africa all have rapidly growing populations. By studying age structures, demographers can predict the future populations of these countries. They use age structure diagrams that use gender and age to determine how large of a population it will become in the future. They use the ratio of children to adults. If there are more children than adults, then the population will increase in the future. And if there are less children in that population than adults, then it will decrease in the future. But of course, not everything can be predicted. natural disasters are bound to happen.
But even though demography can't show us everything about the future, it can help us learn from the past.
And just by watching this presentation, you have taken your first step into a larger world, a world of populations.